Weeks pass quickly, and Renzo Wright has learned many things he thought he already knew. But Foreman Nehemiah and the Cobra Comb Construction Company continue to pull ahead. Things look hopeless for young Renzo. If he doesn't win, he will lose his reward. The use of the 34th floor.
Lloyd, I know sometimes I get mad, but you've always been like a brother to me.
Really?
That's why beating Cobra Comb has been so important to me. If we win, Mrs. Kuhlhaas said we could designate the 34th floor for a new kids' colossal Bible club, where kids all over the city could learn about God's love like we did. That's what my secret floor was for. But now I don't think it will happen.
Renzo, that's the nicest thing anyone's ever failed to do for me.
It's not over yet, Lloyd.
It's over, Renzo. Pack it up and go home.
I'm afraid he's right, Renzo. It's time to pack it in.
We can't give up yet, Mr. Santiago.
Yeah, think of the children.
It's not up to me. We've run out of girders.
Hey, genius! Check your math next time.
Mr. Santiago, that's impossible. I ordered extra. More than we needed.
Sorry, kid. It's true.
Oh, man. Things can't get any worse.
We're out of concrete, too.
Well, that's worse.
Looks like we put too much concrete and steel into the foundation.
What a waste!
It's okay to mess up, Renzo. I do it every day.
No, Lloyd. I did the right thing. There's no way I didn't order the right amount. I know it cost us a lot of time and materials, but to grow big, you have to build on a strong foundation.
You've come up short this time, Renzo. Literally.
Mrs. Kuhlhaas?
What's this I hear about running out of concrete and girders? Renzo, you said you would build the tallest building in the world, but you didn't even get the supply order right.
That's not actually...
Extra, extra, read all about it. Boy genius botches job, reevaluates his genius.
That paper boy is very dedicated to his job.
Mrs. Kuhlhaas, there's been a mistake.
Yes, there was. Hiring you. I'm pulling your contract. You're no longer the chief architect. You're now assistant to the weekend intern. And don't expect to get your Bible club either.
Renzo, you lose!
Oh, God, I don't understand. I've never failed like this before. I did all the math. I was sure we had enough girders and concrete. I guess I really need your help. Truth is, I always have. It doesn't have to be the biggest building, Lord. Please, help us build the best building we can.
Even with all his smarts, the boy architect could not get everything right. But what's most important is that Renzo knew where to turn. Renzo remembered that Jesus had promised he will always love us, no matter what kind of trouble we get into. Jesus is our strongest foundation.
Hi, boys and girls. Welcome back to the construction site. Hey, I just want to make sure that you have your Bible. Make sure and get it out if you haven't already. And make sure you have your badges on your carabiner, because we're going to look at today, we're going to look at Jesus as he laid the foundation for our promise. That's the green badge on your keychain. So, I want you to open up your Bible to page 568. And while you're going there, page 568, I want to remind you where we've been. Remember that our key verse for the week is Philippians 1:6. And we have that right here, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion. Jesus will never give up on you. He started a wonderful work when he created you, and he will not give up on you. He is always pursuing you because his love for you is great. So let's see how Jesus, who is our foundation for love and forgiveness, and our foundation for worth, Today, we're going to see how Jesus laid the foundation of promise. You see, yesterday we talked about how Jesus died for us and how he took our sin and gave us his righteousness, his worth. And so we celebrate that, but it's always sad to talk about Jesus' death on the cross, but we can't leave it there. Today, my favorite part of the story, Jesus' resurrection from the grave. And we're going to see how Jesus rose from the grave, how he spoke to the women who were following him, and how he talked to the disciples and gave them a job to do. So we're excited about today's story. So if you'll go to page 568, we're going to be looking at chapter 28. It's right down here. And we're going to read most of this going to the end of the chapter. So here we go, chapter 28, verse 1. After the Sabbath, at the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to view the tomb. That's the place where they put Jesus' body after he was crucified. There was a violent earthquake because an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and approached the tomb. That sounds very exciting. He rolled back the stone and was sitting on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was as white as snow. The guards were so shaken by fear of him that they became like dead men. In other words, they passed out. They were so scared. The angel told the women, "Don't be afraid, because I know you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen. Just as he said, come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has risen from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there. Listen, I have told you." So, departing quickly from the tomb, with fear and great joy, they ran to tell his disciples the news. Just then, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." They came up, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus told them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to leave for Galilee, and they will see me there." How exciting is that? That Jesus met with the women who were going back to tell the disciples because the angel told them to go tell the disciples. So they were on their way, and Jesus appeared to them alive. And he said, "Go get my disciples and tell them, pack your bags and go to Galilee because I will meet them there." How exciting is that? Let's find out what happened. This is verse 16 of chapter 28. The 11 disciples traveled to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshiped him. But some doubted. Some of his disciples doubted, even though they saw him. Jesus came near and said to them, "All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations." That's all people, all ethnicities, people everywhere, all over the world. "And baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe everything I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." Now, if you were at church on Sunday, we had a baptism, and that was a great and wonderful celebration. And see, we celebrate that someone had decided to follow Jesus, to ask him to trust in him as their Lord and Savior. And at that point, in their heart, they were saved. They had eternal life. But because of this scripture, Jesus says, after you make these disciples, you should baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And that's what we celebrated on Sunday. That was exciting. So now he says, I will always be with you. You know what we call that? We call that a promise. Jesus made a promise, and Jesus keeps his promises. So even when things are tough, even when we look around and we don't know what God is doing or where he's at, and we're in the middle of problems and troubles and just the things of life, we can look to this and say, Jesus promised me that he would never leave me, that he would be with me, not to the end of the week or the end of the year or the end of the century, but to the end of the age. And that means he will be with us until he returns to this earth. And we look forward to that day, but we have hope. We have faith in the promise that he made, that he will always be with us. So we put our trust in Jesus for that. And it helps us to be brave. It helps us to be strong. It helps us to understand that all the things that we have in Scripture are to instruct us and teach us on how to live, and lets us know everything we need to know about God and what he has done for us. And so we wait for Jesus' return, because he made a promise that he would never leave us until that time. So when we look at all the things that Jesus has done, when we look at Philippians 1:6, where he says, you know, that he has made, he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion. He's never going to stop. He's never going to give up. He will be with us until the end of the age, and then for eternity, forever and ever, we will be with him. So I hope that you find some comfort in that. I hope that you get excited about the fact that if you choose to follow Jesus and trust in him as your Lord and Savior, that he will always be with you and never leave. So we have one more day of Vacation Bible School. So I hope you come back tomorrow night. We're going to talk about a great story about how to live our life for Jesus. Now that we've made the decision to follow him, now that we have been saved and we have received his promise that he will always be with us, now what do we do? Well, that's what we're going to talk about tomorrow. So until then, let's go on to the next activity. And before we do that, let's pray. Lord, Heavenly Father, thank you so much that you have loved us with a great love, that you will never leave us even when we don't know what we're going to do. We can have faith and trust that you are with us even in the toughest times and even in the best times. So Lord, we just pray that every child, every parent, every person watching would look deeper into your word and deeper into their heart and make the decision to trust in you as their Lord and Savior, to ask forgiveness of their sins, and to have faith in your death, your burial, and what we talked about today, Lord, your resurrection, and your instruction to us to make disciples. Lord, we thank you, and we praise you for your word. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, let's move on to the next activity.
Welcome, boys and girls, to the second craft night of Concretes and Cranes Vacation Bible School, sponsored by Royal Haven Baptist Church. I hope by this time you've had a lot of fun, and I hope that you've had fun with the crafts. Tonight, we're going to make a roadblock. How fun is that? When you're driving down the street and you see construction, they oftentimes have a roadblock telling you to slow down or quit going or look at what's being built. This says building up one another in love. We want to always be reminded that we're building one another. We're building our family in love, and we're building friends in love. And God loves us. So let's make sure that we do that and often take caution in doing that. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to open your package. If you'll look for this package in your bag, everything you have is right there. Everything you need is there for the project. The first thing you do is you get your first piece, which is building up one another in love. If you need instructions, there's an instruction sheet that comes in the package with it. This is Miss Rhonda, and I'm Miss Melinda, and it's so good to see you again, and I'm glad you're here for our Vacation Bible School. First thing we're going to do is take the piece of stripe tape, okay? We're going to put that across the top. We're going to put one piece here. She's going to do that for us. And this is the easy craft and fun too, because it has great big jewels, and I love those. We're going to take the second stripe and put it across the bottom. And we have two little crosses to remind us about loving one another. God calls us to love one another as He loved us. So that's always a great reminder to know that that's where the true love came from. Okay, so here's the fun part, the jewels that go on. Remember when you're going down the street, they're sometimes flashing, flashing, flashing. So we want to make sure that everybody sees us and know that we can love them the way that Jesus loved us. Well, that's, and you're just going to put one on each. She's going to put one on each one. That's fun. If you have scissors and you want to cut it apart, you can. But you don't have to. Yay. Now all we need is something for everybody to see it, make a sign. So we have two clothespins. Put those on there. Yay, good. All right. Now we have our building up on one another. This was not too of crass. I hope you really enjoyed the time with Mr. Marty and the Vacation Bible School. Make sure you wear your hard hat and your safety goggles anytime you do something that for crafts, don't you think?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Thank you, and we'll see you tomorrow night for our last craft night. See ya. Bye.
Hey guys, I hope you had a fun time on day 3 of Vacation Bible School for Royal Haven Baptist Church, Concrete and Cranes. I had a great time, and today's over. So make sure you come back tomorrow. We'll have more crafts, more videos, more fun, and more Jesus. So let me pray for us as we leave. Lord Heavenly Father, thank you so much for all the people that joined us online today. Lord, I pray that they were able to learn something from your Bible story, that they were able to have fun with the craft that they made. Lord, that they were able to enjoy the singing and the dancing. But mostly, Lord, I pray that everyone had a connection with you and that they would make that decision to trust you as their Lord and Savior. And if they have, Lord, I pray that you would continue to bless them to live a life for you. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, guys, that's it. We've got one more day. Don't forget to come back tomorrow for day 4 of Vacation Bible School. Until then, have fun.